66 degrees at 7:51. It's time for Marketplace.
With all that Silicon Valley wealth and innovation, what fixes its most high-profile city?
Marketplace Morning Report is supported by Viking. Exploring the world in comfort, Viking offers a small ship experience with cultural enrichment and destination-focused dining. More at Viking.com. And by the new Glassdoor app. Professionals can now join real anonymous conversations within their company, industry, and communities and get answers about careers on Glassdoor.
I'm David Brancaccio in New York. Judging from hotel rooms in use and room rates, San Francisco has been lagging major cities in the U.S. in its tourist industry, recovering from pandemic. A San Francisco Chronicle analysis points to one key problem. While tourists are flowing back in from many countries, they're significantly lagging from one very big one, China, a country with an economy that is failing to catch fire. Stories about crime in San Francisco and some big retailers like Nordstrom leaving its downtown may be discouraging others from visiting. I spoke to San Francisco's mayor, London Breed, about these and other issues facing her city. Mayor, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
You're working to get more than 220 more police officers hired. You want 800 prevention places to help people at the edge stay out of homelessness. Will these and other of your initiatives, do you think, Mayor, be enough? Will the narrative that San Francisco is a bit of a mess to be avoided, will that be different maybe a year from now?
Well, I hope that it will be different. I think that it will be considerably different, but this is not just about homelessness, the challenges that exist in San Francisco. We have many issues with open air drug dealing. Fentanyl has risen to crisis level, and we have support from the state and the federal government finally to address some of the challenges around law enforcement. So our goal is to do everything we can from a local level to not only make the appropriate investments to increase our police force, to make sure we have alternatives to policing, to make sure that residents of this city, in all parts of this city, feel safe.
Let me ask you this. I work out of my program's New York City Bureau, and like your city, New York has a huge gap between rich and poor. It has vacant office space galore post-pandemic, like San Francisco. Homelessness, terrible problem here. But as I look out the window here in July, the streets are packed with tourists. There's energy beyond tourism that I'm not seeing as much these days when I visit your city. What accounts for that difference?
Well, the tourists, the visitors are up actually in the city. There are certain parts of the city, like our downtown shopping area, that continues to struggle, but Union Square in the downtown area is typically packed. The Pier 39 and Ferry Building and our new attractions near the Golden Gate Bridge or Tunnel Top Parks and other places, but things have definitely changed. I think the narrative that's out there about the city has had an impact on tourism, but ultimately when people get here, they're like, San Francisco isn't what people told us it was going to be, and hopefully that word gets out as well.
It's such a contrast. I mean, people see these headlines that Nordstrom is leaving downtown San Francisco. And what you're saying is if you actually go to a place like Union Square, there's other action.
Well, let's talk about that, because the fact is Nordstrom didn't just close its store in San Francisco. It closed stores in Canada and all over the U.S. And retail is moving in a different direction. It was before the pandemic. So many of our retail businesses were struggling. And it's a combination of things. It's not just about, you know, concerns around safety. It's, you know, our tax structure is the ability to find workers. However, many of our luxury brands, like the Chanel store, they're expanding. Yves Saint Laurent, they're expanding. A lot of our luxury brands in San Francisco have had record sales, and it's why they haven't decided to go anywhere.
Now, homelessness, a federal appeals court panel is sticking with rulings that give people the right to camp out if there are not available places for them to live. Is this a problem for you in your effort to make San Francisco a place where people come back with their money?
We have run into a lot of problems with trying to clear encampments. And what we do when we go into these encampment areas, we make it clear to folks that we want to provide shelter as an alternative. And some people take us up on our offer and some people don't. It's really a complex, challenging issue. But at the end of the day, when we have a place for people to go, they should not be able to continue to be on the streets where, you know, unfortunately, you know, you have trash, you have feces, you have public health related issues. You have a number of these folks who unfortunately have other issues around addiction and substance use disorder and mental illness. So we need to be able to do our jobs to keep the streets clean and to keep the streets clear so that people can use the sidewalks as they were intended to be used.
London Breed, mayor of San Francisco. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, artificial intelligence has lifted the stock market this year. I wanted to know how this could play to San Francisco's benefit. You can stream the extended version of this conversation from marketplace.org if you missed that on the air today. Retail sales for June just came in slightly lower than expected. The increase of just 0.2% feeds the view that higher interest rates are working to slow the economy. Markets, S&P futures are now down 0.2%.
Marketplace Morning Report is supported by Amazon Business. From small business to big enterprise and everything in between, Amazon Business helps simplify the supplies buying process. Amazon Business, your partner for smart business buying. And by C3 AI. C3 Generative AI provides ChatGPT enterprise search that is verifiable, secure, and accurate across all enterprise data. C3.AI. This is enterprise AI. And by Indeed, a streamlined hiring solution. Indeed helps businesses attract, interview, and hire candidates. Learn more at Indeed.com/hire.
Last summer, J.P. Morgan CEO Jamie Dimon said investors should brace for an economic hurricane, as in a potentially severe recession as the Fed raises rates to fight inflation. Now a research report from a rival Wall Street firm says maybe it'll be no more than periods of light drizzle. Marketplace's Nova Safo has more.
Goldman Sachs's forecast calls for U.S. economic growth to slow the rest of this year, but it expects growth nevertheless. In a research note, the bank echoes broadly held expectations that the Federal Reserve will hike interest rates again next week. Goldman Sachs expects that to be the last rate hike. Meanwhile, the latest economic indicators show inflation is slowing while economic activity is still chugging along. That means a so-called soft landing is looking more likely. Goldman Sachs is reducing the likelihood of a recession from a 1 in 4 to a 1 in 5 chance. Still significant, but nowhere near a certainty. I'm Nova Safo for Marketplace.
And in New York, I'm David Brancaccio. You're listening to the Marketplace Morning Report. American Public Media.